Hunter, thanks again for having me. I'd like to start with the situation involving the fired Cody Rhodes and his brother Goldust, who was in action this past Monday night against Randy Orton in a match which Goldust had to win in order for Cody to get his job back, but in the end, Randy Orton would defeat Goldust.
Yeah, first of all, before we get into that, I want to say thanks again for doing this, Michael. I think that for the WWE Universe, this is helpful to come to some understanding of why I do the things I do. There's a lot of thought behind them. It's not just the, you know, random things that they don't understand a lot of times. So this is very helpful. I'd like to do this on a regular basis to help them understand that. As for, you know, the Cody Rhodes situation, I feel bad. I feel bad for Cody Rhodes. I feel bad for Dustin. But at the same point in time, I gave the WWE Universe what they asked for. They wanted a second chance for Cody. They didn't understand the situation. They asked for a second chance. I gave them that second chance. Through social media, they asked for that chance to be Dustin. And I gave them the second chance, and I gave them Dustin as that second chance. And the unfortunate thing is, Goldust failed. You know, that's a tough thing when the weight of your brother and his family and his new bride are sitting on your shoulders, but unfortunately, Dustin just couldn't do the job against the WWE champion, Randy Orton.
I've read a lot on social media over the past couple of days, and the majority of WWE fans are very upset with the actions of your wife, Stephanie, in the way that she treated Goldust after this very emotional matchup that he had.
Well, I'll say this in defense of my wife and in defense of myself. We are human beings at the end of the day. We're not robots that just do a job. We're human beings that react with emotions to things. And, you know, my wife in a situation when Cody got fired, where the Rhodes family talked about this vendetta and this feud against the evil McMahon family that's been going on since the 70s, you know, it's okay for the Rhodes to attack her family, her father, her grandfather, and make them seem to be these monsters. She's not supposed to get upset about that. And when she does get upset and fire back, she's criticized for it. Did she go too far? Yeah, I think it's understandable, though, and you know, emotions ran high.
Speaking of emotions running high, Big Show has been an emotional wreck over the past couple of weeks. I need to ask you, after what happened this past Monday night on Raw, whether I agree with it or I don't, the fact of the matter is he violated a direct order from you, his boss. Will he be reprimanded for his actions Monday night?
Yeah, you know, again, I'm trying to help the Big Show. I'm trying my hardest to help him personally because I like him. I've been a friend of his for 20 years. And once again, I come out and I ask him to do his job, simple as that. He refuses. Unfortunately, he's a locker room leader. He's a veteran of 20 years. He's one of the most respected guys in this locker room. And I've got to make an example of that, because if I don't, I'm letting the locker room know that it is okay to run rampant here, and it is not. This is a business. We expect people to act professionally. I'm very disappointed in the Big Show as a professional. And personally, not standing up for what is right for his family.
So he will be punished?
He definitely will be punished. You know, this Friday on SmackDown, Big Show has a lot of explaining to do, and I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet, but there will be ramifications. There has to be. I wish there didn't. But I have to. I have to do what is right for everybody else in the locker room.
And speaking of Friday on SmackDown, everyone is absolutely shocked that you've invited Hall of Famer Edge back into WWE to be a part of the show Friday night after everything that went down this past Monday night on Raw. What he said about you, the way that you kicked him out of the building, the anger that built up inside of you, but you're allowing him to come back Friday night.
Sure, it amazes me that I guess people think I'm as small-minded as everybody else is and that I can't see the bigger picture on this. Did things get heated? Yes, they did. Was I emotional when I threw Edge out of the building? Did I overreact? Maybe. But let me ask you this, Michael. Again, to use a reference I've used before with you, if this was any other company, let's just pretend for a second that this billion-dollar industry is a legitimate company that has to operate like a legitimate company. And I am a chief executive officer that brings back a former executive officer of this company to give a lecture. A former executive comes into the lecture, the current work staff, and maybe the stockholders. And when he does, the first thing he does is disparage the company and say that the current direction of the company is bad business. he becomes a cancer to that workforce and to everybody that is listening to him. My only course of action at that time when that happens is, and I'm inviting this guy here under the best of circumstances, but the only thing I can do is go out there now and disparage his credibility. So I do. I go out there and I have to get rid of that component of what he's just put into my locker room and my staff, and I have to discredit him. I do that by telling the truth. I talk about his career, talk about the fact that he is in the Hall of Fame and he is who he is, because he was unfortunately injured young in his career and people felt bad for him and they put him on a pedestal that maybe isn't fair to have him on, but it is what it is. He responded to that emotionally by attacking me and my marriage and saying that I only have what I have because I married into the family, which is inaccurate. I was world champion long before I'd ever even met my wife. You know, it boiled over, unfortunately, into a very personal issue. He then came into my office and attacked me verbally and threatened physicality on me. At that point, I'm a man, just like any other man, and I would never ask somebody not to be a man in this business, and I am that. If you come to me and you threaten me physically, you threaten my family, you threaten my business, you threaten me in front of my wife, I am gonna stand up for it. At that moment, it was the right thing to do. From a business standpoint, did I overreact a bit? Maybe. That being said, does that prevent me from having edge in the show? No. I'm giving the WWE Universe what it wants. So this Friday night on SmackDown, I'm gonna give them the cutting edge. I'm gonna give them what they are asking for. I'm gonna give sci-fi what it's asking for. And not only am I gonna give them that, I'm gonna give them the cutting edge, and his guests are gonna be the WWE champion, Randy Orton, and the number one contender, Daniel Bryan. I'm giving them all that. It's not about my personal feelings. It's about what's best for business.
So Friday night on SmackDown, Daniel Bryan, Randy Orton, two nights away from Night of Champions, are going to be in the same ring at the same time as a part of Cutting Edge.
Let me ask you, do you think that's good for business?
I think it's awesome for business.
There you go. That's why I'm here.